So section 4.4 is all dealing with triangle congruence proofs, dealing with side, 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 and side, angle, side type of theorems. So that's what we're going to work on. We're going to practice proving triangles are congruent using those two congruency theorems. So every triangle congruence theorem proof is going to follow the same kind of general theme or the same general format. We have three boxes, and all of these three boxes together lead us to the third box, or sorry, the fourth box. So these three boxes, let's call them box one, two, and three, they all funnel into box number four. And here's why. So all of these theorems, so for example, if we have side, 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 then we can prove that the triangles are congruent. So what that means is we need to prove each pair of sides are congruent. So we have in box one, this would be one pair of sides. In box two, and also in box three, we have a different pair of sides. And what that allows us to do then is it allows us to prove that the triangles themselves are congruent. So let's say triangle something or other, I don't know its name yet, will be congruent to triangle some other thing. So that's why we're always going to have this three boxes kind of flowing into one. So let's begin our first proof. Let's give it a shot. Oh, I forgot about one thing. Sometimes there are things from diagrams or just how these pictures are drawn that we can consider as kind of given information. So when we have two triangles that share a side, then we can use that shared side in our proof. So for example, triangle side length AB and BA would be congruent to itself. And then also we have the sort of this bow tie type shape. Whenever we have two lines intersect, then we create these vertical angles. So in this case, vertical angles 1 and 2 would be congruent. And that doesn't need to be specifically given to us, but it's sort of one of those pieces from the diagram. It can be assumed given to us. Now we're ready to start some proofs.